Low Pro has a new backpack, the Whistler 450 AW version 2. So, welcome to Dutch Video Shooter. My name is Victor Bart. Low Pro has sent me this backpack for review, so I must disclose that. But my opinions are my own and they will be honest. It's really cold here, so I think we should go to the studio and take a closer look. The backpack is already filled up. It's now 22 kilos with my big Miller tripod and two camera bodies, a lot of lenses, a laptop, some clothes, a water bottle. In this video you can really see what will fit inside. And this video will be a real review and not a stupid vlog where I talk like 1 minute about the backpack. The goal of this video is to see if this adventure backpack fits a gear for a traveling filmmaker that shoots everything from out of his backpack. The straps of this backpack and the waist belt are really good, so it is 22 kilos, but it feels stable on the back and it is very comfortable. I really like this gray color on the backpack. It looks great and it has some orange accents and some orange strap. Let's take a look at the straps here on the side. It holds my Miller tripod and it's very sturdy. Here we have a closed loop, but also this adjustable strap. And here an adjustable strap, and on the other side it's the same. And here on the top we have this orange straps, and they are removable, so if you don't like them you can simply unhook them and remove them. There are extra straps here and there is a little strap here, so you can put a monopod on here or ice hooks or at any adventure stuff. The bottom is flat, so if you put it on the ground it won't fall over. And here on the side there's a pocket and it fits a water bottle. And there are some extra pockets here. But what I miss on this backpack, what I really like, are these mesh pockets from this other Low Pro backpack to put your water bottles in. This is just too much of an effort to get your bottle out if you are making a day trip. We have some solid padding here and here and here. There's a lot of adjustments here on the strap, so you can really get a good fit around your body. And what I like is those hooks here can't fall off. I really don't like this carrying strap. It's way too thin. If you compare it to the Low Pro Protectic 350, this one has a very sturdy handle with some extra rubber. And this is really nice in your hands. But this is just way too tiny for the amount of weight you can put in this backpack. The waistband can't be removed, but what I like about this waist strap is they put it here a bit more to the middle instead of here, so it really wraps around your body and it gives great stability. This part is the camera compartment, so we have some extra storage here. So let's open it. What I like about this compartment is that it fits all your clothes and some personal items, so you don't have to carry another backpack for those items. And here's also a nice mesh pocket for some smaller items. There's an extra zipper here and I unzipped it, so that gives this area some extra storage height. And the inside here is made out of an extra strong material, so if you put in ice axes or climbing gear it won't damage the inside. Here we have the top compartment and it is separate from the camera compartment, so you can fit your chargers and your cables, and your laptop also goes in here. So here we have my Dell XPS 15 and it's a perfect fit for in this backpack, and it is nicely protected between the camera compartment and the front compartment. And they designed the laptop compartment so the laptop won't reach the bottom of the bag. It stays up like 8 centimeters above it. So if you put down your backpack, your laptop won't hit the ground. And here we have the rain sleeve. And I really don't like it like this. It's more like they were thinking, oh wait, we forgot the rain sleeve, so where do we gonna put it? Oh, just put it loose inside. So you can easily lose this And it's quite annoying because a pocket like this is very handy, but it's now half full already with the rain sleeve. I really like it when the rain sleeve is just under in the back in a pocket, so you can always throw it over it and you won't lose it. But let's try out how the rain cover will fit. Okay, this is quite annoying to remove the rain cover. And the backpack is completely filled up and the extra storage areas also used. So let's see if it will fit. Okay, the little bag stays on the rain cover, so you won't lose the little bag. The rain cover is big enough and there's enough room here on the sides. If you have smaller items like a small travel tripod, it will fit under it. But you won't need the rain cover with some light rain because this is a weatherproof nylon material. So only in heavy rain weather you need to use the extra rain cover for protection. Let's check out the most important area of the backpack, the camera compartment. And to open it you need to take off your backpack, because the opening is on this side. You can easily put down your backpack on the side that is waterproof and open it. So now you have access to all the inside. Here we have two memory card pockets and it is 32 gigabyte. I think they need to update that, because the memory cards of today are way bigger. But nice two protected slots, so you can write like full and empty on it and you can easily know where your card is. Here we have a pocket and there's enough room for my memory cards in this holder. And here we have another pocket for like business cards, cleaning cloths, a credit card, step up rings. But what I don't like that it's not a clear pocket, so it's really hard to see what's inside. So this is what can fit inside. I have here a GH3 body with a lens attached, Tele lens. My GoPro goes in this nice divider, and which is also directly a pocket. So this is a nice detail, and I hope they include more dividers like this, because it's really handy to put in all the small things like this mini tripod. I have more lenses. And here my XLR audio adapter, XLR cable, camera strap, longer XLR cable, cleaning blower, a hand mic, an on-camera shotgun microphone, SLR Magic ND filter, batteries here. My GH3 and GH5 batteries are in the sleeves, so the contact points are nicely protected. And a Rode wireless set here, a small HD focus monitor. And I changed the divider so it has really a nice pocket here to slide it in and is protected from all the sides. Aperture M9 LED light, always nice to have a small light with you. And of course it fits my GH5 in a Sakuto cage, so you don't have to break down your whole camera to put it in the back. So you can really pull it out, put on the microphone, put on the monitor, and you're ready to shoot. Inside of the bag there are a lot of dividers and some cushion here, so you can really adjust the configuration how you want it. And if you remove the middle here, you can put in really long tele lenses, and you can remove the upper part here of the bag. So if you don't use it as a camera backpack, you can just make it like one big room here. And you can put in the big dividers also sideways. So if you use a camera like an EVA 1 or an C200 or an FS5, you can fit it also in here. Or you can configure it to have a drone here with some lenses. And it's really a flexible layout, so you can really put it in how you want it. And a really good padding and some special dividers. There's enough room in this backpack to fit my anamorphic shoulder rig without taking it apart. So we still have the follow focus attached. The handle here with start and stop is attached. The whole lens setup, rails, the VCT base plate from Sokuto is under it. There's enough depth in the backpack to hold a setup like this. So also a cinema setup will fit in this backpack. This is what fits easily inside. A 15-inch laptops, a dongle, hard drive, power supply, chargers, audio equipment, a full rig with monitor and microphone, a GoPro, a blower, an extra light, an extra camera body, 5 extra lenses, a lot of batteries, a mini tripod, filters, a camera strap. And of course, we still have room left for the personal items and the clothes. So let's talk about the zippers, because I don't like them. This is a backpack of $400 and there is not a possibility to put a lock on here. And also here on the top compartment, you can't put a lock on here. And here is your laptop inside. Here on the big zippers of the camera compartment, you can put a lock on it, but still, you can open the top and get everything out. So, is this a good backpack for a traveling filmmaker / adventure filmmaker? I think it's a really great backpack. But I see an issue with this backpack while traveling with a plane. Because it gets pretty heavy. So, maybe a bit too heavy for carrying it into the cabin, and you don't want to check this back in. And also, when you put in your extra clothes and you really pack it full, it extends a little bit over the airplane sizes. So I don't really think you can travel with this backpack if you really fill it up to the maximum. So maybe the 350 backpack is a little bit better for that, but the 350 backpack doesn't fit a 15-inch laptop, only a 13-inch laptop. So you can't put in a really good editing laptop. That is the choice you need to make yourself. How much of equipment do you want to carry with you? How full do you gonna put back, and of course which airline you gonna fly with, because some airlines it's not an issue if you travel with this backpack, but other airlines will make an issue of it because they have only a 7-kilo limit for the cabin luggage instead of 12 of other airlines. So you really need to check it out if this backpack will fit in the cabin for the rules. So if you want to know more about this backpack, I will put a link in the description to the LowPro website. If you want to support my channel, you can use Amazon affiliate links in the description to order the backpack or to order other items. Because if you do that, I will get a little bit of money out of it and they won't charge you more of it. So I really appreciate if you want to use those links. Thanks for watching. Please like and share this video, subscribe and leave a comment.